couple of signs. The first one being that one. It's above you, when you came into this fine establishment, you would have seen another two signs, or maybe not. Exit. Turn around and have a look. Exit sign. The big green and white one. Over here, here's another one. Exit. Over there. Now, you will need these exit signs only in the event if we don't like you anymore. Or you decide to leave. Or if there is an earthquake. First, if there is an earthquake, drop, cover, hold. Yes? Yes. Someone will then tell you to make your way to the car park next door. If there's a fire, much the same sort of thing will happen. You will be invited to go to the car park next door. Then we'll just watch it burn. Welcome to the combined Picton Little Theatre and QCC Snow White pantomime. The best way that I can introduce you to your part in this pantomime is to use P for pantomime equals P for participation. So please feel free to participate in this particular pantomime. Please. We'll be safe for you. No, no, it's got the reserved seat on it. We knew you were coming. I didn't want to say that out loud, but yes, you are special to me. Now I know what you're thinking. I can tell that you are thinking you are so privileged to be here tonight to gaze upon this young, fit, healthy, funny and incredibly sexy man. That's what you've been thinking, I know. I've been sitting here feeling it. Unfortunately, I have this, well, fortunately for you at this point, I have this hat on. Unfortunately for you, when the hat comes off, I have to be Gom. Gom is a grumpy old man. It is not typecasting, I have been assured by my wife. When the hat comes off, I have to be a grumpy old man. Now, the cast and crew have been given their 5-minute curtain call. I guess when I sit down, the curtain's all open, you guys will enjoy it, and I'll be grumpy. Oh, well. Oh, boo yourself! You don't have to listen to this rubbish! I just get the dump on it! I hope you enjoy yourself, because this lot, you shouldn't have come. Seriously, it's rubbish! You would have been better at home watching the telly. No. Rubbish! Oh, dear. Watch the show, it's rubbish. Try and enjoy it.
Good evening, and welcome to the Picton Little Theatre. I have the honour of being your host for tonight's performance, Lorella Bumbleclover. We bring you a tale of life and death, of joy and sorrow, of love and hate. You will see creatures that you have never met and go to a place of absolute enchantment. You will be transported, delighted, on an emotional roller coaster of wonder and fear. And what?
What are you on about? This is not a performance of Midsummer Night's Dream. It's a pantomime. Snow White, you know, cheering, booing, slapstick.
Well, I thought I'd bring a little culture, more than yogurt, for the group.
Children, do we want culture?
Boo! Boo!
Do we want silliness?
Boo! better job. Well, anyhow, as I was saying, once upon a time...
Now, hang on a minute.
What?
You haven't introduced me.
Well, I thought you introduced yourself.
Oh, just do your job.
My job? What, you think I get paid for dressing like this? I'm a volunteer.
Well, do your just say your lines.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and everyone else, we bring you a tale of love and mystery in the palace. My esteemed friend, the jester, will help us to enjoy the story when he holds up his signs. You will follow his directions. So now, let's practice. In this story, there is a beautiful princess named Snow White. When she appears, the jester might hold up this sign.
Hooray!
Well done, wasn't it, Jester?
I think they can do better.
Oh, okay. Oh, well then let's try the Wicked Queen.
Boo!
Oh, shut up!
Now, in this play, there is a mirror. The mirror and the Wicked Queen. The mirror and the Wicked Queen are supposed to sing to each other, but we auditioned hundreds of actors for those parts, and no, we are not going to let them sing, so... So, no, it's good news, cause you guys get to do it. Now, this... Oh, we're not in halves anymore. This half of the audience-ish is going to be the mirror. And this half... No! You guys are the queen.
Yeah.
My apologies. Yeah. I was testing you. That half is going to be the queen, and this half is going to be the mirror.
Wait a minute. Are you sure you have that the right way round? I mean, this side has to be intelligent because the words change.
Well, she looks intelligent.
Oh, yes. But what about him?
Oh, I see what you mean. A few sandwiches short of a picnic, don't you think?
What? Rude! I'll have you know that I've written the book!
Oh, really? About what?
Sorry, what was that?
Constipation in theatre audiences.
Sorry, say one more time.
Oh, constipation in theatre audiences.
What? Well, now we know why his face looks like that.
Bro, get on with it.
Yeah. Teasing them the song.
Yes.
Now, it is to the tune of Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. Mm. If you don't know that song, don't worry. You can sing it to the tune of the ABCs instead. Now remember, this half-ish is the mirror, and this half is the queen. Ready?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Magic mirror on a stand, who's the fairest in the land? By my reckoning, you're the best. You're a cut above the rest. Magic mirror on a stand, she's the fairest in the land.
Oh, very good.
Yeah, did you come here to sing?
Yes.
You did. What is wrong with you? Can you please get on with it? I paid good money for this rubbish.
Yes, darling. We were going
Don't
on.
Don't call me,
so,
darling.
So, once upon a time, there was a wonderful kingdom with a beautiful king and queen, with Queen was expecting a baby, and everyone was so happy. When the time came, she gave birth to a beautiful baby girl, and they named her Snow White.
Hooray!
Unfortunately, the queen died shortly after. Fortunately, Snow White was raised by a loving nanny.
Hooray!
Unfortunately, the king remained terribly unhappy. But fortunately, he met a beautiful woman and married her. Unfortunately, she was only beautiful on the outside. Inside, she was wicked and hated Snow White. Fortunately, the king and Nanny protected Snow White from the evil queen as long as they could. But unfortunately, the king died, and Queen Lilith was left in charge of the kingdom until Snow White would turn 21. We pick up the story just before Snow White's 21st birthday.
Nine more seconds to go. The little braces are wrong too, by the way. You should be six scenes in Act One, and there's two less in Act Two. I don't know what's going on here.
Now we must call this meeting to order. Is everyone here?
I am.
And me.
Well, yes, I can see that. Is anyone missing?
I wish I was.
That can be arranged. Is anyone missing?
Not me.
Nor me.
Never mind. Now let's just get on with it. As you know, we are here to discuss a ceremony and a party. Snow White is going to be turning 21 and will take over the realm from Queen Lilith.
Not if I have anything to do with it.
What did you say, Queenie?
Never, never, ever call me that. And I didn't say anything.
Were we inviting a handsome princess?
I want to meet some handsome princes.
I heard handsome princes are usually shallow.
I can live with shallow.
I can be shallow.
Marriage is forever. Handsome fades, but shallow doesn't.
Finally, something sensible has come off that stage.
Well, of course it has. It all makes sense. You just need some dollars.
I used to be handsome.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Oh, yes, I did.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Oh, yes, I did.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Oh, yes, I did.
Oh, no, you didn't.
We invited Prince Algernon from the next kingdom. I have his picture.
On the ground.
It's on, he flew. He has some wings too, Doc. Yes, he does. Now, is this not magic?
He's gorgeous.
Yes.
Dreamy.
Wow. So, you could marry him, and you could live in his palace, and help him run his kingdom, and
No. The kingdom went to his older brother. But he's very rich, and he will bring his fortune here.
But is he shallow?
No. He has first honors in economics.
Oh, no, you could be up to something here.
I can't wait. I think I'm in love.
A smart inside this girl, you see, belle of all society. Not too strict, but rather free. Yet as right can be. Never forward, never bold. Not too hot and not too cold. Just the very thing I'm told. And in his arms he'd like to hold.
Who's booing me?
Perfection. Time for my daily check in the mirror. Magic mirror!
No. We told you not to sing. We need a paying audience.
I can do this. Magic mirror!
No, stop. They can do it for you.
Oh, all right, go on then.
Time for you all to sing again.
Magic mirror on a stand, who's the fairest in the land? By my reckoning, you're the best, you're a cut above the rest. Magic mirror on a stand, she's the fairest in the land.
Hey. I'm the fairest, I'm the best. But what am I going to do about this stupid girl Snow White? She'll come here and where will that leave me? Out on my ear, I ask you.
Out on your...
This is a family show, we might be thinking it, but we don't say it. Thank you.
I'm going to have to come up with a plan. Tommy! Where is that lazy boy? Tommy!
Yes, Your Majesty.
Where were you?
I was playing with Snow White. Tennis. I mean tennis.
I know what you're thinking.
I don't pay you to play. I pay you to work for me.
You pay me?
Yes, it's food and board and travel costs.
But I don't travel. You keep me here.
But I might need to send you somewhere, so I need a contingency fund.
So how much pay do I end up with?
Oh, you stupid boy. You're in arrears.
$3,854.
I'm taking it out of your pay. With interest. Anyway, I need to think of a plan while you're killing her.
So, is she still the fairest?
Well, just, but I'm dreading the day that I have to tell her that Snow White has overtaken her.
I reckon.
What do you think she'll do?
I don't really want to say, because I quite like you.
She'll throw something at me, won't she?
Maybe. Although, I don't think she wants to risk 7 years bad luck. She might put me in the basement.
Oh, no, I hate dark, damp spaces. Oh, what am I going to do? Perhaps I'll just pretend to be asleep.
Yeah, I don't think she's going to fall for that one.
Tommy, are you listening to me?
Yes.
We need to come up with a plan for Snow White before the party.
My little girl is all grown up. You are so beautiful.
Emily? Really?
Perfection, my dear. You couldn't be more beautiful if your fairy godmother had waved a magic spell over you.
She's right, you know. She is the most beautiful girl in the world. And in that dress, perfection.
If I could get her married off to someone on the other side of the world, but she's such an ugly little thing, who'd have her?
Ugly? Oh no, she's beautiful, gorgeous, dreamy, perfect face, perfect body, and on the inside too. Generous, nice, kind, sweet.
Sort out your history, speech.
Yeah.
Whatever you think, I'm still the most beautiful in the realm. What? What are you trying to say?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
You just told me I was the most beautiful. I couldn't have changed that quickly. Oh, for goodness sake. Magic.
No! Jester. Hello? Did someone call?
She's trying to sing again.
Oh, no. You'll have to cover for her, but Mirrorside, be careful. Some of the words have changed this time.
Magic mirror on a stand. Who's the fairest in the land? Snow White has the perfect dress, and so she is now the best. I can only tell the truth. You are losing out to youth.
I can't lie, it's not in my program.
She can't be more beautiful than me. Why? I have 10 times the makeup budget she does. Ask them at Picton Healthcare Pharmacy. I am the best customer. They give me great cosmetics at reasonable prices. And my white teeth, that's to the Picton hygienist. And that's even free, provided you get your teeth checked there once a year. And my plastic surgeon, well, he can afford to holiday at the Trump International Hotel in Hawaii.
What can I say? Snow White's a natural beauty.
That's it! She has to go! I need to plot and plan and scheme and collude.
Oh, for goodness sake, you're done, my head, and get on with it.
You. You have to get rid of it for me.
No, but
how?
Take her for a paddle down the sounds and kill her!
But why would she want to come for a paddle with me?
Oh, tell her you want to talk about her party. Then take her to a lonely bay and kill her!
But I've never killed anyone before. And she's so beautiful.
Never, never, ever call her beautiful in my presence. And you will do it, you ungrateful boy.
And if I don't?
Then I kill you. Painfully, slowly, after you've watched me kill your pet dog, your pet rat, your cat, your lizard, your goldfish, and your axolotl.